Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I want to take you through today just what shortcuts is and how you can apply it to your life, so stay tuned. So shortcuts are intended to automate little tasks that you do with your iPhone or your other iOS devices like an iPad. And it's also intended to automate a little bit of your life. So this, when comparing to either Amazon Alexa or the Google Assistant, this has a little bit more of a focus on your life and your time with your phone here. So the applets are centered a little more around the native functions that show up on an iPhone. What's also really important to talk about here is the fact that Siri is here to give you suggestions for shortcuts, and then on top of that, to execute some of those shortcuts for you. So you're not actually having to tap on different items to execute those. So let's walk through some of the basic functions here with shortcuts on my phone. First off, I'm going to scroll over to what's basically the widget screen now, and I'm all the way at the top and I just pull down. Now what you'll notice is Siri suggestions, and we've had these before showing the applications that I use quite often, but you're also noticing down below sending a message to Mark. Now, Mark is someone that I send messages to at this time on these days in this location quite often. So Siri is now suggesting that as a shortcut for me. So if I tap on that, it takes me straight to the messages screen and it doesn't fill in any message. But I could add that later in the shortcuts. I'll kind of show you that as we go through things on the channel. But right now, I'm over in the messages application. I have Mark pulled up and we're ready to send him a message. So you can see how that shortened my timeline, and it also kind of triggered me to think about doing this. So switching over now, I want to show you the actual shortcuts application. You can see it there in my menu. It used to be workflow, like I said earlier, but it is now called shortcuts. Now within here, there are a number of things that I had already previously created. This would be empty for you. And top right, you go ahead and you click that plus, and you get started creating a shortcut. Now, on top of that, Apple has given us a number of suggestions to start using this application. You can see that there's shortcuts for sharing. They have what they're calling wonderful, running shortcuts in other apps, which I'll show you in a minute, and shortcuts for music. There's also all kinds of other shortcuts down here that they've pre-created for you. What I'll say, again, is it functions around a lot of the native applications that are here in your iPhone or iPad. So something that I think we're going to see more and more of is the health related stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and create a health related shortcut. We're not going to go really deep into the functionality here, but let's go ahead. So you can see the log water routine or shortcut here. I'm going to tap on it. And what you get up right away is it says, it works with the following apps and services. So it gives you a list of what it's working with, and you can see it's just the health one here. And if you want, you can show the actions before you kind of get into this. So you can see that this is a list with, I think that's ounces, and it's going to ask you how many fluid ounces, and then it's going to log it. So you can see how it's kind of flowing. You're going to choose a number. It's going to ask you that question as you choose that number, and then you're going to log that in your phone. If you wanted, you could change things like the value. So fluid ounces in US, that's not something I would normally use here in Canada. So let's go ahead and tap Get Shortcut, and it's added to my library. So it's already there. I just tap over and I can go ahead and tap Log Water. So you can see how many fluid ounces of water did you drink. I can go ahead and just tap 16. So for the first time I'm running this application, you can see that I have to allow some permissions. So I've gone ahead and selected those. I hit Allow, and now it's logged that water in my health application. So you can see, you could log meals, you could log water, you could log exercise, you can do all of those things in a relatively automated fashion. So now from here, this looks like, okay, I've got to go into the Shortcuts application all the time. No, you don't. There are a number of ways. Remember, Siri is going to suggest this to you. You can also talk to Siri, which I'll show you in a bit, but you can also tap on the three dots here. It gives you the editing screen. If you wanted, you could edit what it's asking you for, the different options that you have to choose from. The value in fluid ounces, you can see I can switch to milliliters for myself, and you can do a number of things here. If you wanted to set a different date, you could go ahead and do that. I don't know why you would. But what I really want to talk about is the couple of icons at the top of the screen here. This is essentially your share icon, and you can see that I can actually tap on the plus where it says add to home screen. I could also share it online. Lots of people are doing that right now with Shortcuts, so you can find resources for that. You can also obviously create this or duplicate the shortcut and create a slightly different version. So if you wanted one for logging water and you wanted one for logging something else, you could go ahead and do that. Now, you can see that it's just telling you the things that you have to do here. You just tap again the share button, roll over a little bit, add it to the home screen, and then you're just gonna tap add. Now, that's an icon now on my iPhone, and anytime I tap on that, I'm running the little shortcut here, and you can see that I can do it again. It's run it, I'm done, and I can leave the application. So that's all that has to happen for executing one of the shortcuts. All right, now there's another component to this, and of course, I think this is what everyone's going to care about, is how do you control it with Siri? Now, inside of my log water shortcut that I just created with you, up in the top right, there's the two switch icon. And when you tap on that, you're going to see the add to Siri button. Now, adding to Siri allows you to say whatever you want. You can kind of set any phrase that you want to get Siri to trigger this applet or this shortcut. So I can say something like log water. And now, anytime I say that to Siri, she's going to use this shortcut and start it. So I've hit done, the Siri phrase is log water. You can see that I can show it in the widget. You can see also that I can show it in the share sheet. So that's the icon whenever you're in another application and you tap the share button, it will show up here to go ahead and log water as a shortcut from anything. So this would obviously be more powerful if you were using social media or something. To go ahead and share items. That's not really going to be a big deal for logging water. But now that we've done that, and I hit done a couple of times, I have my log water shortcut all set up. Now I can go ahead and ask Siri to do the same. So let's do that. Log water. So you can see right away, it brought up the whole shortcut. I can go ahead and tap 12 ounces in this case, and it's now logged that water. There's nothing else I need to do. So you can see the functionality, really powerful actually for running routines or running little things that you do all the time. I've added it to Siri. There is a little bit of setup work here, but this gives you a pretty good baseline for what Shortcuts is and how to use it a little bit on your iPhone and iPad device. So, thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.